Hello and welcome to this Design Cuts video tutorial, and today we're looking at the pen tool in Photoshop, and this is going to be an introduction to the pen tool. If you've come from an Illustrator background, you're probably already familiar with the pen tool, but if you've only worked in Photoshop, you may not know that it exists and you may not know how to use it. So today we're going to look at it. And the pen tool's over here in my toolbar. So I'm just going to click it to select it because that makes accessible some of the options for the pen tool. Now over here, we've got the option of making a shape or a path. And today we're just going to make paths. So I'm going to click on path. In earlier versions of Photoshop, you might have icons here. So just select path. Now over here is a little gear icon. It's a little bit hard to see, but it also has a little disclosure triangle underneath it. I'm going to click this and make sure that rubber band is selected. Your version of Photoshop may not have the rubber band option, but if it does, select it. And we're also going to select auto, add and delete. Now the pen tool can be used a couple of ways, and one of the ways is just by clicking it. So I'm just going to click, 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 click. And when I hover back over the starting point, you can see that the cursor changes to a little O beside the pen tool telling me I'm back over my starting point, and I can click here to close my path. And that's a nice little closed path. So you can operate it as a straight line tool. I'm going to delete this path. So I'm going to this tool here, which is a path selection tool. I'll select over my path, press the delete key. The second way that you can operate the pen tool is to draw what are called Bezier curves. And this is where things can get a little bit confusing. So what I'm going to do is click and drag. So I'm not just clicking, I'm clicking and dragging. And what I've got here is an anchor point and some handles. And these handles are controlling the direction that I'm going in. And so because I clicked and dragged upwards, that's where my line is going. So let's go over here and click and drag in a downwards direction. And now my path is heading in this direction. And let's click and drag up and click and drag down. Now I'll press the escape key to stop the pen tool from drawing. And what I've got here is just a line. It's an open path. Let's go to the path selection tool and we can click on our path. Now all of these little boxes are what are called anchors. And we can change the position of these anchors and change their handles even after we've drawn our line. And we do that with this other tool, which is called the direct selection tool. Now, some people call these the black arrow key and the white arrow key and feel welcome to use that because it does help when you're learning them to know which is which. Well, the direct selection tool, the white arrow key, is the one that we can click on an anchor point to see the handles, and we can swing these handles around to change the shape of our curve. Now, right now, you'll notice that these handles are working in sort of teeter-totter style. I drag one up, the other one goes down. Sometimes you want that for your curves, but sometimes you want your curves to go in one direction at the top and another direction at the bottom. So in this case, you'll hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac, and you'll just hover over this anchor point until you get the little plus sign beside it. Now, you want to watch really carefully at this point because, confusingly, Photoshop also uses the Alt or Option key to make a duplicate. So you don't want to make a duplicate of part of your line, you just want to move this point. So you're looking for the white arrow key with the little plus sign beside it. And that tells you that Photoshop's listening to you and it's ready to break the connection between those two sets of handles. So you can swing a set of handles in an opposite direction. Let's go and select this point. You can see that it's black filled when we've got it selected. These are all hollow because they're not selected. Here are the handles. They're operating as a teeter-totter by default. If we want to break them apart, we hold the Alt or Option key and just hover over this point. Look for our little plus sign. That tells us Photoshop is listening to us and doing what we want. And we can just swing this point around. Now, sometimes you might want to take a point like this and make it into a straight line. Well, you can do so. There's a tool here that is called Convert Anchor Point. You'll click it and then you'll just click on this point to change it from the way it is right now, which is curves, into a straight point. And so this now doesn't have handles. There are no handles on this point. When I click and drag over it, you can see no handles. It's bending in and out of the curve because these are curves. So these handles here are controlling the curve in and out, but this is a pointy point. Now, if we want to convert it back, we go back to the Convert Anchor Point tool. So I'm going to click on that tool to target it, and I'm going to click and drag away from this point. Now, it's coming out a bit twisted, so I'm going to untwist it before I let go of the tool. And I'm going straight back to my Direct Selection tool. I want to use this tool just to break up the point and make it a different type of anchor point, but I want to go straight back to the Direct Selection tool when I'm actually manipulating it. And so I'm going to drag on it, and you can see that it's operating as this teeter-totter again, not unexpectedly. If we want to break it, hold the Alt or Option key and drag on it to break the connection. You'll let go the left mouse button before you let go the Alt or Option key. And now the teeter-totter has been broken and we can reshape the curve as we like. Now you can also add and remove anchor points. So let's go back to the Pen Tool collection, and underneath the Pen Tool is an Add Anchor Point tool. Click on it and you can click on a path and just add an anchor point. Once you've added it, you would go back to the Direct Selection tool to manipulate it. Likewise, you can remove an anchor point. So I'm going here and selecting the Delete Anchor Point tool. Select the tool and then click on an anchor point to remove it from the path. Right now you're probably thinking, okay, fair enough, that's what the pen tool does, but how am I actually going to use it? Well, let's go and see one application of the pen tool, and that's to make your own shapes. And I'm going to show you how to make a symmetrical shape. So we're going to start with the pen tool. And I'm going to make a guide, so I'm actually going to drag a guide in from the side of the document here. I've got my rulers showing. I selected view and then rulers. So that means I can just drag a guide in from the side of the document. I'm going to hover over the guide here to start my line. So I'm just going to click and drag, and I'm going to make a heart, but I'm going to make a symmetrical heart. So I'm going to click and drag downwards here, and I'm going to click in on this finishing point here. I'll press escape to stop the pen tool from drawing. Now I'm going to the Direct Selection tool because I want to make sure that these points are right over this guideline, and I'm not totally convinced that that's the case. So I'm going to zoom in, and with the Direct Selection tool, just going to make sure that this is snapping into position. You can feel the snap when it snaps into position, provided you've got your snap tools on. So let's go and see what they are. I've got here, snap is turned on, and I've got snap 2 set to guides, layers, and document bound. So those settings should then allow you to snap your anchor points into position. I'll press Control or Command 0 to zoom back out. At this stage, I don't need my guide any longer, so I'm going to choose View, Clear Guides. I'm going to select the Path Selection tool because I want to select this entire path, and I want to make a duplicate of it. So I'm going to choose Edit Copy, and then Edit Paste. And it doesn't look like anything at all has happened, but I've got one path on top of the other. Let's just see. Now I'm going to undo that because I want those paths directly on top of each other. I don't want them to move. I'm going to bring up my transform controls, and I can do that by pressing Control or Command T for transform, or I can choose Edit Free Transform Path, and that brings up these controls. And what I want to do is I want to flip this shape over to here. So I'm going up here into this little set of 9 boxes, and I'm going to set the rotation point for this shape to the middle box on the right hand side. And you can see here this little indicator has jumped across to this point. So that means that anything I do now is going to be done relative to this point. And what I'm going to do is go up here to the width. I'm going to make sure that this icon here is disabled. I don't want what I'm doing to the width to affect the height. So I'm just going to leave that as it is. I'm going to come in here and press the minus key in front of the width. And that just flips the shape over. And I'll click the check mark. So I'm going back to my Path Selection tool. Right now I've only got this side of the path selected. So I'm going to select over the whole lot, just dragging over to select the whole lot. And I want to join these together. So I can have a look in the paths palette here. This is my paths palette. If you don't see yours, choose window and then paths to display it. You can see here that it's white in the middle and gray on the outside. So that's telling me that right now this is going to be a nice little heart shape. We could fill it with color. We can do all sorts of things with it, but it's still two paths. So I want to join them together. So I'm going to this drop-down list here. And right now it has selected exclude overlapping shapes. But since this little picture is perfect for me, I'm just going to ignore what the setting is because I just want this picture to show. So you'll just want to go to a setting, it doesn't matter which one it is, that gives you the picture that you want to see. So there's two options here that do that. Exclude overlapping shapes and combine shapes. They both work to show us the white heart with a gray surround. That's exactly what you want to see before you do the next step. And we'll just choose merge shape components. And that merges these into a single shape. Now, if you get a line down the middle, you're going to have to start again because it hasn't merged correctly. You should just see a single shape. And this is now a shape that we can use at any time in this document. But wouldn't it be nice to be able to use it at any time, full stop? Well, because it's a shape, we can go to edit and then define custom shape. And so we can actually make it a shape that is going to be available through the custom shapes options in Photoshop. So I'm just going to click OK. So that's one use for the pen tool. The other use for the pen tool is to make a path to cut out an object. So let's see how that would work. I have here an image of a cute little retro car, and what I want to do is to cut it out of its background. Now there's plenty of ways to do it, but one of the best ways for an object like this is to use a path. So what we're going to do is go to the pen tool. I'm going to zoom in so I can see the car pretty clearly because I'm going to make a selection around the edge of it. So I'm going to the pen tool, I'm going to click and drag to start my path, and then I'm just going to click and drag at locations around the car and just drag out my curves so that they mark out the area of the car that I want to cut out. I'm going to use the Alt or Option key as I go to reshape the line. That allows me to shape it as I go. And I'm going to vary between clicking and dragging just depending on what I want the line to do. So let's have a look here. Up this side of the windscreen, it's pretty straight. So I'm probably just going to click and then just start the curve very shallow over here. I'm going to come up to about this point. I'll click and drag and just round that curve as I'm going. But you can see here that the line is taking off through the middle of the car. So I want to move this handle just a little bit. I'll hold down the Alt or Option key and just drag this handle up to break the connection so I can head off here across the top of the car. And again here, I'm going to Alt or Option and just pull up a little bit. I'm running out of space, so I'm going to hold the space bar down, and that changes my cursor into this hand so I can move my image. Let go of the space bar and we're back to the pen tool. So what I would do is go all the way around the car here, making my selection. Now I might not make it perfectly, but I'm going to make it as good as I can on this first run. You probably don't want lots and lots of anchor points, so there's a sort of learning curve in terms of determining how many anchor points you need, and generally I'll put them in after a curve. Now, this one isn't looking too good right now, so I'm going to hold the Alt or Option key and just drag on this handle to try and remake it. Now, if things get out of control at any point, just press Control Alt Z, Command Option Z on the Mac to wind back, and then you can just pick up your line at the last point where it made sense. So again, here Alt or Option, because I want to take off over the trunk of this car. Again, Alt or Option as I'm drawing, just to make this curve here. Drag this out a little bit around here, drag it out, and so on. I'll use Alt or Option to change the handles, and I can use Control or Command to move the anchor point. So you can see here I can actually move this anchor point while I'm drawing it, provided I hold down the Control or Command key, and then with Alt or Option I can just reshape my line. So there is a little bit of sort of mental coordination needed to use this, but let's have a look and see the result, because I'm just going to finish this for now. I'm not going to go all the way around the car with you, but I want to go to another version of this image that I have where I have already made my path. Now, if you'll notice up the top here, it's a JPEG image. One of the benefits of these paths is that you can save them inside JPEGs. So if you've got a path here, by the time you make it, you'll want to go and double click on your path and just call it something other than work path. So I'm going to call it car on the one that we were working on. When it's called car, and if we save this as a JPEG, then that's going to be saved with our file. So over here is one that I made earlier. I've got the path here. I can click on it to select the path, and it's now a path on my image. Now I can use this to make a cutout. So here in the bottom of the paths palette is an option which says load path as selection. So I'm going to click to load it as a selection. Let's go to the layers palette. We'll unlock the background layer here. And at this point, we could invert the selection and delete the background. But we can also do something else. I'm just going to deselect the selection here. I'm going to click on my path to select it. And we can make a vector mask. Now to do that, I'm going to hold the Control or Command key as I click on the Add Layer Mask icon. In this case, we get a vector mask. Now the beauty of a vector mask is that it's a vector, so in here is our path, and that's what's controlling what we're seeing on the screen. So if we want to make changes to it, for example, let's just go and get the white arrow key. I'm just going to show you what happens when I grab a point and change it. You can see that the path, this vector path, is controlling the cutout on this image. And so if we have a look at it at this point and think, well, we didn't do particularly well on the wheel here, or we left something out here, or we went too close to the car or too far away from it, then we can come in and adjust the vector path, and that will adjust the mask on this image. Now, while these paths will save inside JPEG images, I would, just for safety's sake, always save a PSD version of the file as well, just in case something goes wrong, because you don't want to spend hours making a really beautiful path, save it in a JPEG, and open up the JPEG and find that you can't find it. They do save. All you do is just save your JPEG as normal. And provided you've got a named path, it's not work path, it's just the named path here, it should save in that file. But as I said, I would be prudent and always save a PSD version of my file as well. Now, I hope that you've enjoyed learning the basics of using the pen tool in Photoshop. Please let us know what you think in the comments below and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, I'm Helen Bradley for Design Cuts.